So you've got your seed down, or you've done your renovation, and now the time has come. You need to water. Today, I just want to take a couple minutes of your time to discuss this important step in your renovation or your overseeding process, how much you should water, when you should water, why you should water. So let's just take a couple minutes and go over that. Once you've got your seed and fert and all the other stuff that we put down during overseeding or renovation time down on the soil, the time has now come to keep it moist. Seed to soil contact is king, but the thing that is kind of right after that is keeping that seed wet. You need that seed to stay wet so that it can germinate and grow. Also, once it sprouts and becomes a young seedling, you want to make sure that you're watering properly to encourage the right kind of deep root growth, and also to make sure that the rest of your lawn doesn't just rot out. When I do an overseeding or a renovation, I start by watering every single day, 3 times a day, once in the late morning, once when the sun is at its highest point and it's the hottest of the day, and then once before the evening time to make sure that it can carry through the night. I do not water first thing in the morning because the dew that's on the grass will actually take care of keeping that area of your lawn moist. So we get a little help from Mother Nature there, and we don't have to worry about watering early in the morning or first thing when the sun comes up. So for me right now, I have a Project Spoon Juice out there that is being watered 3 times a day, basically on 4-hour cycles that start around 9:30. And then my next one is 4 hours later, 1:30, and then another 4 hours later at 5:30. As far as how long to water, it kind of depends on the spray pattern of your sprinkler. It's just about keeping that seed moist. If you have the opportunity to keep an eye on those first few days when you set up your cycle, maybe start with 20 minutes. And go out there after each of your watering cycles and in between them and check and see and make sure that your peat moss or your dirt or whatever is moist and that your seed is not drying out. If your seed dries out, it's almost a game over. Water every day for 3 times a day, about 20 minutes a cycle until you have germination. Once you have germination and you have those little grass seeds growing, you want to go ahead and start backing the water down. This is where I would decrease the time in each of your cycles from maybe 20 minutes to 15 minutes for a few days, then down to 10 minutes for a few days. We don't want to keep pools of water all over the place or keep a lot of water. We're working more towards that deep and infrequent cycle that we always talk about. We want to make sure we get those seedlings to drive their roots down deep and not keep them up towards the surface. So go ahead and back down your watering about half per cycle of what it was doing for a week or so. And then after that, you can probably start to take some days out of your watering cycle. So maybe every other day instead of every day. And keep working that back down until you get your new lawn or your new section or your newly overseeded section on the same schedule that you were following during the season of deep and infrequent waterings. This is a question that comes up a lot, so I just wanted to take a couple minutes to answer it today. If you have any questions, please leave those down in the comments section. And if you haven't checked out my videos on how I did my overseeding this year, go check those out. They're pretty cool. They're pretty fun. So that's it. That's all I got for you guys today. Quick tip to address a hot topic. And as always, if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments. I'd love to chat with you. Thanks, and I'll see you in the next one.